Okay, so this is the moment of truth here, where we actually really open up to everybody and lay it all on the line.
And tell them who you're related to?
I guess, if we have to go down this road. Good morning from Fort McAllister State Park, just outside of Savannah, Georgia here. Do you guys want a cup of coffee, by the way? I can go throw one on real quick. Nay, still in bed. I know that's what you're thinking. She's slowly getting out. I assure you she's awake, but Dexter's in there laying with her right now. And when those two get together, it's kind of like it delays the process a little bit. And there's no telling when they'll actually make it out of the bed. I'm going to let you guys in on a little secret. These state parks are where it's at. As the kids like to say, it's money here. I don't know if that's what they really say, but I'm going to go with it. Best part about these state parks is the sites are so big, they're so spaced out, and they're very well maintained. It's very clean. We noticed over the years of being at RV parks, it's nice to have all the amenities, but what's really cool is when you land spots like this, because we still have all those amenities. Yes, we do not have to rely on a dump station. We have full hookups at our site right now, so that's pretty cool. And much needed, because we still have the crack in our gray tank. We're gonna walk you through our whole process of getting that bad boy fixed. It's been months we had this gray tank cracked, and we've been keeping our gray tank completely open the entire time. That way when we have showers and brushing our teeth, it just runs all out into the sewer. So we've kind of been having to be flexible and landing spots that guarantee us a full hookup site. And if we don't, if we're dry camping for maybe one night, we just are very judicious with our water usage, and we make sure we don't fill up the entire tank, because if you guys remember at all from that previous episode, the crack is actually at the top of the tank, so we can use a little bit of that tank capacity with no worries, but we have to be concerned if it gets too full, because then it might, you know, compromise that seal I had placed earlier, and y'all know how that went the first time. I feel like today's gonna be a good day, and I am so glad you guys are here. I love you guys. I have the trash, so please do not let me forget it. Should we sing the trash song while we're on our way? Everybody should have a trash song, something that is so easily forgotten. How many times have we left it on the back tailgate and then hit the road and we're
all
like,
all the time.
You threw me off my beat. What's going on here?
My watch went off. Sir, please don't block the container.
No, it's fine. Thank you.
Bucket list items are getting checked off today. Am I allowed to say that at my age? I have heard so many great things about Savannah, Georgia. And to put the icing on the cake, we get to do it with you guys.
You know what's interesting is we have to figure out how we're gonna park this big truck in downtown Savannah.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm not a city person, honey. You know, me with the lifted truck, I stick out like a sore thumb in the cities. My question is, all the people that drive dualies out there, what do they do? Because they have a big, fat butt. You know, it's like...
Well, we used to like cities when we were younger. Like, the things when you were younger, you were like, boring. Why is that on fire?
Help me.
So I did my research, and here's the things I wrote down that we could check out.
Forsyth Park.
Chippewa Square, which somebody from your family sat there in a bench.
Said something about a box of chocolates.
River Street along Savannah. I'm hoping we could just park along River Street, and then that'll be where we end up. And then there's a lot of bars and restaurants on Bay Street. And we are headed towards Pigeon Forge, the Smoky Mountains. We're so excited. Maybe we'll do some really good hiking there.
It will be here before you know it.
Oh, we're hitting the traffic already. What is all this traffic for?
This is us trying to get to the UPS store traffic.
You gotta run those errands. Who needs to see Savannah anyways?
That's fine. We'll get there tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Awesome.
I hope we make it there today, because I would like to see it before we leave.
Surprisingly, there's no traffic now. It was just near 95, which has already given me scared vibes for tomorrow when we have to drive 95. We're supposed to
go that way.
It's gonna rain today. It's gonna pour, and I'm thinking this is gonna make the city less crowded, so it might be a blessing in disguise. We're gonna have to get off the next exit and then
we're lost.
Get back around.
You know,
know it would be a blessing in disguise if I could get some good directions.
Now you're going to have to make a left and then another left to get back on the interstate. To backtrack.
Yeah. I wonder why that is.
Let her rip. Can't fit there. The truck might be a little too tall.
So this is the ideal location to find parking. Everyone, it's raining. Time to go home.
Anywhere like here.
I think this is always the most stressful part of any time we go anywhere.
Yeah.
Finding parking is that's a hashtag relatable stress.
We made it.
This is amazing. You want to go out sometime?
I'll be here all week. It's so crazy because traffic is right there and I'm like,
Look at this. Look at that handy dandy parking spot. Carl, you done good.
Hi, we gotta pay parking.
Oh, yeah, that would be important. I'm gonna let you take care of that since I got this done. Bye for now.
Until 8 p.m. tonight, which I don't even think we'll be here that long. 571 total.
You shut the front door.
That's pretty good.
Oh, all right, I'll meet you there. No, we're going this way.
This way.
This way.
This way.
No, come I have our friends here. We're going this way.
No, we're going this way.
No, come with me, guys. Ever.
So, we got here. We got parked.
See what I have to deal with? It's always about her. Excuse me.
I think the plan is to go.
Hello.
To a brewery now, wait for the storm to pass, and then we can just start walking. And we'll burn off all those beer calories. Hello. See, he's finally here.
Wow.
All right, I'll race you.
I knew it was this way. So far, Savannah's not that bad. We've been in a lot worse cities where it's more hustle bustle and kind of integrated. It doesn't feel like a city because it feels like you're in a jungle, like a jitty. Get it?
Like
jungle
that.
City.
I don't like that.
Okay.
Don't do that again.
How about a jungle?
Stop.
Trailer park.
Who did I marry again?
The mother of trailer park. Oh my gosh, guys. My life is complete.
Mine's not.
So the rain just came and gone already.
What? It's gone.
I thought it was going to be a torrential downpour, which is why we booked it to this brewery. If you guys are planning day trips in the south and the weather says it's going to rain, don't let the weather decide whether you're going to have a good day or not. Just go for it.
Something's kind of telling me I shouldn't have wore pants today, by the way.
Why did you?
Because it was going to rain and I'm used to with rainy days it being cold.
No, it's muggy. It's the south.
Yeah, it's hot, humid, but I could get used to it. As long as I have AC to refer back to. That's important.
People watching.
That's always fun to do. What are you feeling for dinner tonight?
Something with a nice view.
Oh, honey, as long as I'm in the company of you, I have the most beautiful view of all, so.
Nice one.
There are just so many squares in the city.
I was just about to say, guess what's coming up? Another square.
Don't be so square. Did you know it's hip to be square?
That's enough, Abby.
Huey Lewis in the news.
You're cut off already. Stop.
I only have one beer.
Too many.
That is epic looking. And I love this. These trees and the moss, it just does it for me. It's so cool.
Oh my gosh, I forgot. I need to call Dexter and make sure that he does his chores. I'll be right back.
You have a cell phone for that. This lady is absolutely crazy. I cannot believe I call her my wife. Oh my gosh, and I thought Carl was crazy. See what you guys got yourselves into? It's like a fire or a disaster you can't look away from, isn't it? You wanna tell me what that was about?
The door doesn't open. Someone told me. I'm like, how am I supposed to call Dexter?
What are you looking up?
I'm posting a story of you filming in the wild. I'm looking for a gift that says Crikey.
Crikey? You mean Crikey.
Crikey. I said that.
Crikey. Crikey.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's... how do you spell that?
Crikey. Is that what I said?
Does this situation give all you full-time RVers PTSD looking at this? It's like when you're at the RV park and the dumpster's full and you don't know what to do with your trash and you have full trash. Yeah, we're at a beautiful park, but I'm pointing out the trash that's here. So that's how that day's going. We made it. We walked a treacherous 1 mile to come get you. But hey, we're here. So you know what we need to do?
What?
Let's take a selfie. Ready?
All right, let's go home.
Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Are you from around here? All right, nope, nobody's sitting here with me. Great.
Okay, so we're in front of the Chippewa Square right now. If you guys don't know what that is, that's a popular place for the beginning of a really popular film called Forrest Gump.
Oh, yeah.
If you've never seen that movie, well then, oh my goodness, where have you been? Basically, the moral of the story is I am related to Tom Hanks. And yeah, you may think I'm joking, but this is all serious. This is legit. I have handwritten letters from the Hanks. Yeah, I'll have to throw a picture up to prove it. And if you're seeing the picture right now, I'm that little fatty right there he's holding back in 1991, so.
Can you see it in his face maybe a little?
Or my personality, I don't know. The relation is my grandpa and Tom Hanks's father were cousins. So I guess that makes my dad second cousins of Tom Hanks. Pretty cool story is my dad actually met him a couple times back in our hometown.
Yeah.
Because that's where his mom's from. If anyone knows how to get in contact with Tom, send him my way so I could say hi, because it's been a while. It's been a minute
it's
since 91. It's been a second since
yeah,
I said hi.
Time flies.
You never know what you're gonna get.